So, can we start, Manisha ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
A very good
So,
morning to one and all present here today. I, Swati Sharma, welcome you all on the seventh day of the long 15 days e-faculty development program. Geeta Ratan International Business School was established in the year 2004. GIBS is affiliated to Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, Delhi, and is approved by All India Council for Technical Education, Ministry of HRD, Government of India for its management courses, and Bar Council of India for its law courses. The institute is accredited as A grade by NAC and assessed as category A plus by Joint Assessment Committee of Government of Delhi and Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University. The institute conducts postgraduate courses of MBA, MBA International Business, BBA, BBA LLB, and BA LLB. Faculty development and regular upgradation of teaching skills are very crucial aspects of any educational institution, irrespective of its modes of operations, whether it is face-to-face or through online mode. This pandemic situation has brought the education to a halt, and as a result, the student's future is becoming uncertain. The present situation has posed the challenges of conducting teaching and research in the virtual environment. Most thought leaders are of the opinion that blended form of learning is going to be the future of education. The topic for day seven is technique of correlation and regression. Statistical method involved in carrying out a study include planning, designing, collecting data, analyzing, drawing meaningful interpretation, and reporting of the research findings. The statistical analysis gives meaning to the meaningless numbers, thereby breathing life into a lifeless data. The role of statistics in research is to function as a tool in designing research, analyzing its data, and drawing conclusions therefrom. Today we are covering the techniques of correlation. Today we have with us Mr. Harendranath Tiwari, who has joined as a special guest to share his knowledge on this topic. Mr. Harendranath Tiwari is an assistant professor at Commerce Department, Sri Ram College of Commerce, University of Delhi. He is an alumnus of Department of Commerce, DU, from where he has obtained his post-graduation degree in MCOM. He's currently pursuing PhD in finance from Department of Finance and Business Economics. Mr. Tiwari has contributed a number of research articles in national and international journals and has published several books in the area of computer application and financial accounting. He has also conducted several faculty development programs on research methodology and on the use of Excel and SPSS in teaching and research and executive development and training programs for officers of Indian Railways. He regularly conducts students' workshop on use of Excel and SPSS for financial decision making. He has over 14 years of experience of teaching and training UG and PG students. He has authored 3 books. We welcome you, sir.
Swati, he is presently associate professor.
Okay.
So this is for he is now from, I think, January onward, he is associate professor. So I think your profile was not updated. So we welcome Mr. Tiwari for this session.
Thank you very much, sir. And there is no fault of Swati on this part. What college has done that they have upgraded the associate professors list, but in the introduction they have it's still written assistant professor from where she must have downloaded the details.
Okay.
So it's not her fault. It's on the college part. I'll ask them to correct it as soon as possible.
Okay, fine. We welcome you. Okay, fine.
So thank you very much, sir, for inviting me, and of course. I have been associated with this great institution. I have been resource person to last two, I think in 18 or 17, 2 years I came for factor analysis and it was a wonderful experience while interacting with you people. And I'm hopeful that many of, or some of you at least, will be definitely constituting the group who have, or with whom I have already interacted with. And the great part is that Sir has offered this time correlation and regression. So something new, and we can have some discussion over it. And it was, of course, when a call was received from Hoti Sir, I could not even ask for a second thought. And I immediately said, yes, sir, we'll do it. And thanks for inviting me, sir. And thanks for the wonderful introduction. Of course, the data analysis techniques are important. The problem with numbers is, but before I start, just would like to ask, we have a 3-hour session, and in between, do I have to give a break, or it will go continuously? And if a break has to be given, then around what time it should be?
It depends upon you. Like, you can take it the way you want. When certain, like, you know, major, maybe after 1.5 hours, you can give a 10 minutes bio break. Yeah.
I do think so, because then concentration level can be maintained. So fine, around 11 o'clock, we'll have a little break. So let's start discussion on it. Yes, the beauty of the numbers is that if you heartbeat the data will speak. And it'll speak what you want. So there is the problem where we actually encounter. When we write research papers, we generally notice that a technique has been there because we want to apply the technique. Whether that technique should be applicable or not, that's sometimes it remains a questionable thing. Of course, we are going to discuss with numbers only. And throughout the discussion today, we will be having, we will be using Excel and SPSS as the software. Some manual calculations I will show using Excel, and some more data sets, the heavy data sets when we have, we'll be doing through SPSS. So what I was saying, that once you have the data and you put it in the software and say, give me a number, it gives you a number. But whether that number to be interpreted in the same way which you want. You just gave not the data, it gave you number, and now you're interpreting the way you want. That becomes questionable if there is no theory to support it, or there is no logic to support it. So whatever we are going to do in the data analysis today and the tomorrow, fortunately we have two sessions, so tomorrow we will be discussing on regression. We'll first understand tomorrow that what kind of data, if we have, on which a particular technique can be employed. Now, to start with today's lecture, we are actually going to learn and understand the relationship or association between two or more set of variables. Now, what does it mean? When I was thinking of this topic, how to start with the topic, one very prominent and frequently used saying came to my mind, and that says, practice makes a man perfect. Now, practice makes a man perfect means what? Now, if I interpret in the way of association and causation, there will be two different meanings coming out of it. Now, it means if I practice more, my performance will be better and it will be nearing perfection. So if I take these two variables, they are varying in same direction. I'm moving towards perception, perfection, and more hours I'm putting in as practice. But every human being has a fatigue. Beyond a particular level of stress, you cannot even practice. So then what happens to your perfection level? So whether one variable is moving into in similar direction or in opposite direction, or one is causing the other, that will be the discussion of the day and the day tomorrow. And before I start, let's look at the data. Here, credit rating is given to and number of occasions on which the shares were undersubscribed, fully subscribed, or oversubscribed. First of all, would like to know what kind of data it is. And I'm assuming that we know the three types of data: nominal, ordinal, and the ratio scale. So if I ask you about that, what kind of data it is, what comes to your mind? Anybody can please try. And there's no right, no wrong thing. Okay, fine. I mean, it may confuse, it may not confuse, it's perfectly all right. But are we understanding the data well? What kind of data do you see over here? Can someone tell me? This is categorical data where we have bond ratings and we have undersubscribed, oversubscribed, or fully subscribed three categories. This bond rating is orderly data. So it is not purely categorical data, rather it is ordered data. So I can put a rank, I can assign rank 1 to AAA, rank 2 to AAA, AA, and rank 3 to this, and so on. So when I can rank in it in some order, it means this is an ordered data and this is a categorical data. Now, if I have to talk about association, a degree of association between them, how can I talk about? Let's have another example. In an interview, there are 10 candidates and two interviewers. And they're ranking the candidates on the basis of their performance. Two interviewers gave different ranks. And I wish to understand whether two interviewers are, or their opinions are, their rankings are correlated or not. Are the interviewers who are evaluating these candidates, and we are assuming that these interviewers are ranking independent of one another. What do I mean with that? I remember when we used to conduct our scholarship interviews, merit-based scholarship interviews, we used to ask a certain number of questions. And when the students used to go, some teachers used to say, "Acha, how was the performance?" Now, in that case, his ranking or her ranking is actually based on how others have assessed. Then this data is not independent data. Here, we are assuming that these two interviewers are ranking them independently. Now, if they're ranking them independently, and these are ranks, they are ordered, so they are ordinal data. And if this is ordinal data, can I calculate the association between them? Can I calculate correlation between them? Can I say the two views are concurrent or not? If yes, to what extent? Most commonly used type of data. In a test, two subjects were tested, English and Maths, and each student was supposed to answer and they scored the given pairs over here. Now, if you look at this data is out of 100. The marks scored by a student out of 100. Now, it could be any marks, and therefore, this is your ratio scale data, and all mathematical operations are possible over here. So we may have categorical data, we may have ordinal data, we may have a data set like this, which is ratio scale data set. And the question against us is, the question before us is to identify, to find out ways and means through which we can say whether the response is correlated or uncorrelated. right? So we are going to discuss measures of association or correlation. We are going to discuss measures of association or correlation. Okay, and here, when we calculate a correlation coefficient, it basically gives us the degree and direction of the relationship. Right, it gives us degree and direction of relationship. So how strength, or what is the strength of the relationship, and whether they are moving in the same direction or they are moving in opposite direction. Let me explain you. I understand that many of you are very senior and you must have done this number of times, but I'll try to give it a different look, and I've tried to bring in new things that might be new for you, and maybe a new thing to that we will be learning after this session is over. So if we have certain data set x1, x2, x3, x4, and so on, we try to find out the sigma, and when we divide by n, it gives me x bar. That's very simple. Every one of us knows it. When we take a deviation, xi minus x bar, x2 minus x bar, x3 minus x bar, and so on, and when we sum these deviations, the total turns out to be zero. What does deviation mean? This deviation means that the observation is how far the observation is from mean. So we want to see how far the observation is from mean. And of course, we calculate our standard deviation by squaring these deviations, and it is sigma I goes from 1 to n. It is xi minus x bar square divided by n. And of course, it is whole square root. This standard deviation tells or gives a standardized value which says how much my observations are away from mean. So these deviations are important, are provide us an important set of information. Now let us have another variable set, y. So same thing can happen with y. y1 minus y bar, y2 minus y bar, and so on, yn minus y bar. So these are deviations observed minus expected. So here also we are saying how far my observed value is from mean. Now if I want to see the movement of x with the movement of y, I want to see how many times. So if I make a graph like this, sometime this value will be negative, sometime this value will be positive, sometime this may be negative, something like that. Similarly, we can have y values. Sometime they are observing a positive, negative, negative, positive. And we want to understand if x is observed to have a negative difference or deviation, whether y is also supposed to have a negative deviation or not. If yes, we believe they are co-varying. Or zaruri nahi hai ki negative hi ho, but what kind of variation is, and if the variation is happening, whether that variation is happening with linear relationship or non-linear relationship, we'll discuss it later. But just to illustrate what I was discussing over here, let me take you to an example which I shared with you, and this example is of very simple, and we will make chart and we'll understand what I wanted to say, because examples make the things more clear. So this is information about a data set which talks about, this is number of times an advertisement has been seen by a particular respondent, or it has been shown or telecasted in a week, and the number of packets of a particular product that is sold in that particular week. And we want to understand if it deviates from mean, how much deviation we observe over here and whether there is any deviation or not. So if we want to calculate deviation, we can simply calculate. This data set is available with you, advertisement and packet sold data. Now, first thing I'm trying to find out is deviation, which is deviation, which is talking about X minus X bar. X minus X bar, estimated value of X. Okay, so if I want to compute, as you of course know, that if I want to calculate average in Excel, I can simply go for average. And I can simply take the values. And this will give me back the average. And we see the average of advertisement telecasted is approximately 9. And the average packet sold is on an average 11. Now, if I want to see the deviation, I can simply calculate this deviation, which is X minus X bar. And because it is constant, I can fix it by pressing a dollar sign. If anyone has any problem in understanding this part, I can definitely explain. And how can I communicate with the teacher if I wish to? Or if some teacher is, Swati, can you please help me? How can
Sir, there is an arrangement in that room where the faculties are sitting. They will ask the question whenever they are having a doubt.
Right, because I have minimized the window, so I will not be able to see any message. I won't mind. Please switch on the mic and just tell me. I will definitely explain that. Right?
Sure.
Now,
sure,
it is some, yeah. When I'm starting, this seems to be a little, you know, that you have already done. Agreed. But just wait for a while and we'll take you to the calculation of correlation, and I'll show why I'm doing this. Okay, now let me compute the deviation of y, which is actually y minus y bar. So this is y minus y bar fixed. And now I want to show this using a graph, and we'll notice what is happening with the deviations, because everything is working on these deviations only, right? So if I want to do that, what I can do, I can simply insert a chart, an XY scatter plot, and this XY scatter plot, I'm simply, and I'm assuming that you know how to make a scatter plot here. If you don't, please feel free to discuss with me. Today, when we are in the class, we should forget that we are teachers or professors or senior professors or junior professors. We are all learners. I'm also a learner. You are also a learner. Just take that spirit and just ask the question, any question if you want. I will try to answer that with full of my capacity, full possibility of understanding of mine. I'll definitely try. So let us select data, and to select data, you can simply right click and select data. And I'm just going for adding two series, and it will show you the deviations, right? Series one is deviation of X. X values are 1, 2, 3. I'm just going for observations. And Y values are actually the deviations, okay? Y values are deviations of X. And let's make a chart. Similarly, I will add one more series. So add a series with name DY. This is deviation of Y. And the series X values remain the same, serial number. And Y values are now deviations of Y. And now appreciate how the behavior of the observations are. Now I'm removing the unnecessary grid lines. They are not required right now, so I'm just removing them. Now look at the observations. Because we have already find out deviations, the mean of deviation is zero, and you can appreciate this, that you see what is happening. This is deviation of y. This is deviation of y, and this is deviation of x. This zero is now the mean of my observations, because I have found deviations. What was deviation? Deviation is deviation of x is x minus x bar, xi minus x bar. So because and when you find out the average or expected value of these deviations, it is always going to be zero. Expected value is actually mean. Okay. Now, what you see here, that when we take deviations, of course, it is negative, it is negative, it is negative, it is negative. But this is more negative, this is less negative. I'm not worried about more negative or less negative. What I'm looking at, that if I observe a negative variation in X, I also observe a negative variation on Y. On an average, please remember, all these calculations, observations, every conclusion is on an average. There may be individual observations where we may have a different thing. For example, look at here. Look at this. For this pair, this is a positive deviation and this is a negative deviation. This may happen. That's not a problem. But on an average, what is happening? On an average, we see when there is a negative, on an average both are negative. When there is positive, on an average both are positive. So these deviations are going like that. And this variation actually is called covariance. So we can compute covariance. And how to compute covariance? A covariance can simply be computed as, from covariance between x and y is 1 upon n sigma x minus x bar into y minus y bar. So this is nothing but deviation of x and deviation of y, and their product is summed and divided by n to get the covariance. This is the formula for covariance. Definitely do continue with this with my Excel example. Right. Let me delete. Deviation of y is equal to y minus mean of y. And what is the problem with this system? We'll understand after this. Okay, what is the problem with this covariance? Why we are not using it? Okay. So let me continue with the dx into dy thing. Deviation of x into deviation of y. So when you do this, we get this product multiplied by this product. And now you see, if both are negative, the product will be positive. If both are positive, the product will be positive. But if one of them is negative, the other is positive, the product will be negative. So we see there are three or four products which are negative and rest of them are positive. Let us find out this sum. We have Excel, so we don't need to use calculator, and it saves a lot of time of ours. And we get this is covariance between x and y. This is covariance between x and y. This is sum of deviations. Sum of deviations. So this is sigma dx dy. What is covariance then? Covariance between x and, yeah, it is equal to divided by n. So this becomes this value divided by 10 observations. So this gives me a covariance of 6.61. Now, what will be the standard deviation? Now, there's no need to calculate manually. We have functions, and now onwards, I will be only going with functions. So to use covariance, we simply use covariance as function. And if it is sample, use dot s. If it is population, use dot p. I'm assuming it to be population. It will ask you covariance between two arrays. Give one array, the original array, give a comma, give the second array, and you will notice the covariance figure is given, which is same here. Sample aur isme sirf ek fark hota hai, that is degrees of freedom, that uses n minus 1. That will use, if you use sample thing, it will use n minus 1. So your covariance will be slightly higher. Now the question is that what information does this covariance give? This covariance gives the information about whether deviations are in same direction or not. So this talk gives me about strength and direction. Now direction is, because this is positive, I can say these two are positively related and these two are not positively related. These two are positively related or these two are negatively related, it could be, if it is going in the reverse order. Then why are we talking about correlations? Why can't we work with these covariances only? Can someone suggest why can't I work with covariances? Anybody? Because covariances have a limitation. And the limitation is they depend upon units of measurement. I'll show you the units of measurement se wo kaise depend karte hain. Theek hai? So rest of the information I'm deleting from here right now. No other information I'm showing here. Nothing. I'll just have some computation over here. Because now we understand that we know Excel functions, so we can calculate these using Excel functions. So average, this is average. Let us have standard deviation, and standard deviation calculate karne ke liye we can simply use STDEV. Standard deviation, give the reference, that is the number of observations, and we get the standard deviation. The standard deviation that we get here is 4.847. And when I take it to my right, it calculates for y, which is 1.6464. Here, more standard deviation means more variation over here. And less standard deviation means less variation from mean. Okay. Now, what about the covariance? So let's have the covariance. And here you will appreciate why we do not use covariance, rather we focus on correlation. Okay, so covariance between x and y. So this is x, comma, this is y. And this becomes 6.61, which we computed manually right now. Now I'm taking to your situation that it is not packets sold, rather these are 100 kgs of packet sold. And this is, so that means it is not only numbers, but these numbers represent hundreds. And I want to compute, the covariance for original numbers. So what will happen? What I will have to do with them, that I will create a new column, which will simply be multiplying this with 100, or generally hota na thousands mein hum de dete hain numbers, ke the numbers below represent in thousands, units in thousand, number of advertisements shown in thousands, number of packets sold in thousand, something like that. So if we simply multiply with 1000 and we get these observations. Now whatever is happening with every other observation. Therefore, my covariance should be same. So we calculate covariance here, and when we compute covariance, between variable 1 and variable 2, it gives us something else. This is the covariance. 66 lakhs and 10,000 becomes the covariance. देखो कुछ भी नहीं है, data is same. Data is same. Multiplied with 100,000, sorry, and we see the covariance has actually gone like this. चलो एक और transformation करते हैं. We will be doing it as a transformation which is actually standardization. Or let's have a deviation from mean. Simply deviation from mean. If we take deviation from mean, it will be equal to original figure minus average of all these observations. Observation minus average of it. Right, and this gives me the deviations which we computed earlier, the same deviations. और उन deviations के बीच में covariance निकाल के देखते हैं क्या होता है. So this is one value minus average of these observations, of course freezed, and now you have the deviations. And if we take these deviations and try to calculate covariance, what will happen to this? Same population covariance we're computing for all three transformations. Notice here the covariance is different. वो तीनों से is this some error? Should not be seen. Should not be seen. Okay. So now we noticed here that when we change the scale of operation, or the metric in which it is actually, I did it manually also, but I'll try to find out, figure out what has happened here, and I'll let you with this mean transformation what happens. I'll definitely let you know. Okay, if we subtract any constant, constant, not average. Average से तो फिर वो almost same रहेगा, क्योंकि वो moment ही तो लेता है ना. Average नहीं, constant. Sorry, I put it a wrong thing. Suppose if I subtract a constant from each observation in both the series, if I subtract a constant from both series, what do I notice then? Arey ha. Yes. So if we transform it for origin, we notice this origin transformation. Please give me some time. This part I'm leaving for the time being. Just going back on this scale operation, and we notice that when the scale was increased, this is actually giving me. And after the break, I'll just check and come back to you, because I just tried yesterday also and I found it was a different one. Okay. Now, because we notice that we are getting different covariances here, if we standardize these units, we will have the same correlation. So let's use correlation here. And when you use correlation, you will notice there is no problem with correlation thing. So this correlation is 0.8315, and when you take it here, this correlation is also 0.8315. So this correlation coefficient that we get here, which is Clark-Pearson correlation coefficient, is actually free from change of origin and change of scale. For origin covariance, I will definitely come back after this break thing, but I don't want to waste time over here. क्योंकि कुछ इशू है, आई चेंज द लैपटॉप एंड आई जस्ट सी व्हाट इज, मैं शायद कोई फंक्शन गलत लगा रहा हूँ या क्या है, मैं मुझे एक बार चेक करने देना. सो दिस इज कोरिलेशन कोफिशिएंट व्हिच इंस्टेड ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट वी चेंज दिस स्केल वी गेट द सेम लेवल ऑफ कोरिलेशन. नाउ लेट मी टेक यू टू द कन्वर्जन. व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन अ डेविएशन एक्स माइनस एक्स बार is actually divided by its standard deviation, it's standardized. So the correlation is nothing but standardized form of, it is nothing but standardized form of covariance. So how do we write it? The correlation between two coefficients, two variables x and y is covariance between x and y divided by standard deviation of x and standard deviation of y. This is known as Clark-Pearson's product moment correlation coefficient. So this is on Clark-Pearson's, and this is applicable only for scale data. This correlation coefficient can be computed only for scaled data, right? So you could manually do it. We have correlation here, we have covariance here, and we have standard deviation of x and standard deviation of y. So if we want to compute the correlation using this formula, it is very simply covariance between x and y divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. And this gives you the same value, correlation coefficient to be the same over here, right? So this was the idea behind it, that first we try to locate what are the deviations and whether the deviations, ab aap yahan dekh rahe hain ki if it is increasing, it is also increasing, but there is no decrease over here. So how can you say if it is decreasing, whether it is decreasing or not? So to look that, if we take the deviations from mean, this makes it more clear that whether the movement is in same direction or on the opposite direction, right? And then that determines whether the correlation will be positive or whether the correlation will be negative. So this is about how we calculate Clark-Pearson's correlation coefficient. So let me go back to, so it has shown two things. We have seen here that it is 0.83, which is very close to 1. This Clark-Pearson's correlation coefficient, as you all know, lies between plus 1 and minus 1. This lies between plus 1 and minus 1. So if it is close to positive 1, we believe and we say that it is near perfect correlation. I mean, it is positive 1, it is perfectly correlated, means both are moving in tandem in the same direction with same strength. There was one more thing, what is linear? Now this Clark-Pearson correlation is available for the variables that are linearly correlated. That means if you want to set a relationship between the two, the relationship should be y is equal to mx plus c. If this relationship is settled like this, we can say it is a linear relationship between two variables. But this forms causation. This seems to be causation, but this is not causation. That just talks about association. So let us proceed with our examples further. So we understand that correlation is study of covariation between the variables, and it refers to sympathetic movement of variables either in the same or opposite direction. If the variables are moving in same direction, it is positively correlated, and if they are moving in opposite direction, it is negatively correlated. When two variables move in sympathy with each other, so that changes in one variable is associated with changes in other same direction, they are said to be correlated by one and same thing. Now I'll show you with an example with the files that we have already discussed. With the files that I have discussed with you, that how we can guess, or what is the first step to understand whether there exists a correlation between two variables or not. And that we will be doing using SPSS. So can I assume everybody knows how to import data from Excel to SPSS?
Yes,
can I assume?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now please understand that correlation is not causation. There may be causation. I'm not saying there may not be causation, but it is not necessarily causation. And where it is, when we are calculating correlation coefficient, it is not talking about which variable is causing what. That you can test using your quick test hota hai na aapka, Granzer causality. That may tell you what is happening first, and based on that you can determine. Or the best thing to determine whether there is a causal relationship or not is the theory. If there's a theory, there's a price and quantity sold. There's a theory that a higher the price, lower will be the quantity sold. So price is causing the quantity sold. That kind of relationship is causation. When we calculate correlation, it is not at all causation. Then what it is? If you can remember, aapne pehle bhi R kiya hoga in any case, this R, Karl-Pearson coefficient, once it is squared, we get coefficient of determination. Coefficient of determination. And what does it say? What is the shared variance? What is the shared variance? So if there are two variables X and Y, their R is, let's say, 0.7. Their R square will be 0.49. So what we can say? We can say, I'm not saying X is causing Y or Y is causing X. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying, they have a shared variance. Variance in one, 49% variance of one can be explained with the help of the other variable. But which variables variance by which? That will depend upon the theory. That will depend upon the model you are, or the logic that you are propagating. But this will give me a shared variance, that these two have in common this much of variance. So if they have in common this much of variance, one can explain the other to the extent of this much. Okay, so this is not causation. Partial and multiple correlation ke baare mein main baat karunga pehle. Yes, I take this example. This example says that when there is more ice cream sales, you can notice here, when there is more ice cream sales, there are more shark attacks. And when there are lesser ice cream sales, there are lesser shark attacks. Do you agree with this?
No, sir.
The thing is written on here, but of course there is no correlation between G. Someone is saying something?
Sir, there is no relationship between these two terms, sale in the sale of the ice creams and sharks attack.
Yes, that is what we started with. I said in the starting itself that if you have two series and you try to find out correlation between two, it will give you some correlation. But that may not be the true thing. For example, here, what theory is there behind ice cream sales and sharks attacks? There is a third variable. This is known as third variable problem. There is third variable. And that third variable is, see the season. May, June, July, September. This is the season when the weather is hot. People go out, swim in sea, and they enjoy ice creams. So this behavior is actually modified by the weather. So weather is causing this association. It is not that shark attacks are causing ice cream sales or ice cream sales are causing shark attacks. Right. I had to discard and I just kept it. Just hold on. Another example, let's take. Actually, I changed my laptop. So there are a lot of, in the break, I'll change my laptop to the older one. And it has a better battery backup. So I just decided to do it. Look at this. Causation may not always imply correlation as well. I'll do an example with you today. And that says, if stress increases, of course, if there's no stress, and particularly for us as an Indians, the stress level definitely improves our performance. But that may not necessarily, to beyond a particular point, if you increase the stress level, your performance may decline as well. So there may be association, there may not be association. This is causing. Causal relationship to hai yahan pe, but may not be a correlation between them. Okay. Next is, how to see or measure the correlation. The best thing to see the correlation with is the scatter diagram. And I have, in my PhD, I'm using a relationship between two variables, leverage and promoter shareholding. So I'm saying leverage is function of promoter shareholding. Now, kya beauty hai machine ki? When I was making chart, I said to machine, give me a linear chart. And it made. I said, give me a non-linear chart of degree 2. And it gave. Kaun sa loon? Which one is right? And I was confused. And I had to discuss with my, because whatever instruction you will give to the machine, machine is a dumb thing. It will give you the output. The best thing is what we did, we made a chart. But agar main model banau, that leverage IT is actually alpha plus beta 1 promoter shareholding IT plus error term, this will do, kya problem is me? If I make a model that leverage IT is a function of alpha plus beta 1 promoter shareholding plus beta 2 promoter shareholding square plus error term, this will give answer for this also. But whether I should put this or not, that's important. So the best thing that you should do with your data first is make a graph. And when you make a graph, you will be able to appreciate the kind of relationship that exists between the variables. This is the best thing you can do, make a graph. Let us see how to make this graph. And in that, we will be using data set which I shared with you and will be doing in SPSS. And the data set is anxiety score, exam anxiety. Exam anxiety. This data set we will use more. And in this exam anxiety, let's understand what the data is talks about. This data talks about three variables, which are continuous variables, and one variable, which is a dichotomous variable, either male or female. This is revision time in hours. This is the performance, exam performance, and this is the anxiety. Look at here. If you want to understand what the variable is talking about, you can simply go to variable view and you can check what is talking about. So revise is the time spent on revising. Exam means exam performance in percentage, and anxiety means exam anxiety. And I want to create a graph of it. Now, there may be different things we wish to know. First, is there a relationship between exam anxiety and exam performance? Number one. Number two, is it different for male or female? Number three. Now, my exam anxiety depends upon what kind of revision I have. So if I do not control for revision time spent over there, then I cannot make out a true relationship between exam and anxiety. Ye jo controlling hai, this is partial correlation. Lekin ispe main abhi nahi ja raha. First, let's understand simple correlation between exam and anxiety. Of course, we are not saying that this correlation value is, we are not saying that this correlation value is a causation. But generally, kahin na kahin hamare mind mein ek rehta hai ki what is independent and what is dependent variable. So if I talk about these two, okay, which one is dependent variable and which one is independent variable, what will you say about it? Exam performance is dependent or independent? What do you think? Anxiety is dependent or independent? Exam performance is dependent or independent? What do you think?
Sir, exam performance is dependent variable?
Absolutely correct. Exam performance is the outcome, and the outcome is the dependent variable. No. Independent, dependent variable. Exam performance is your outcome. What is your outcome? The outcome is dependent. And the one thing which is causing this to happen is
independent.
So exam anxiety is independent. So if I have to understand with that point of view, this I can have a relationship. This is Y and this is X. Correlation we don't give as Y and X. Both can, any one of them can be X or any one of them can be Y. But while we be plotting it, jo hamare mind mein hota hai na, dependent kaun sa, independent kaun sa hai. We keep dependent on y-axis and we keep independent on x-axis. So let's go to make a graph, and to create any graph, we have to go for, to create any graph, we have to go for chart builder or legacy dialog box. Aur yahan pe main kya karta hu? Let's make a simple chart builder. We'll create a chart on our own. This view appears before you, so I simply went to graph, chart builder, say okay, and in gallery, I selected the kind of chart I want, scatter plot. And I'm selecting the second one. Pehle first one lete hain, simple scatter. Simple scatter. When you double click on it, it will ask you what do you want to keep on y-axis and what do you want to keep on x-axis. Okay, so now I keep exam performance, simply drag and drop, simply drag and drop. I want to put exam performance on x-axis, y-axis, and anxiety level on x-axis. Okay, nothing, doing nothing else, simply press OK and we get this output. If you want to draw a line, what you can do, simply double click on the chart. And when you double click on the chart, it opens the chart properties where you can edit your chart. I repeat, whatever chart is available to you in SPSS, you can simply make a double click, and by making a double click, this will open the chart editor window wherein, look at this, add fit line at total, add fit line as total. So the last row mein add fit line hai, fourth option, fifth option, simply click on it and close the window and you will notice a fit line has been there. I don't know what is the correlation between the two. I don't know what is the correlation between the two. But what we can see here, this is the fit line, and this fit line has an R square of 0.194. Can you notice over here? Linear line has been put in over here, and 0.194 is my R. That is 19.4% is shared variance. 19.4% is shared variance. Okay, now what do we notice over here? Look at this level 60. We notice that a little anxiety was good because all people were, you know, performing well here. But as it went beyond the threshold of the 60, I'm just looking at this line. I notice most of the observations are here. Some of them are performing good, but many of them are not performing good, which is causing a negative association between the two. So this graph gives me a clear direction that there is a negative correlation between the two. How to compute correlation? Well, that's very simple. Any computation analysis you have to do, simply go to analyze, correlate, and bivariate. Partial abhi nahi kar rahe, aaj hi karenge, lekin abhi nahi kar rahe. Bivariate, exam performance and anxiety, both forwarded, and we are computing Pearson's correlation coefficient. Click OK. And we notice here that there is a significant impact of, there is significant association between the two, the exam anxiety and the exam performance. And we notice that that association is negative. Ab dekho, ye jo minus 0.441 hai, if I multiply this minus 0.441, and I find out this square term, it is 19.4481. So 19.4%. It gives me 19.4% as coefficient of determination. This is R square. Yahi tha na usme chart mein, you just see the chart. That's also giving you the same thing. R square is 19.4%. So we can say that they have a shared variance of 19.4%. That means if one is dependent or other is independent, that independent variable can explain 19.4% variation in the dependent variable. Which one is dependent, which one is independent, you have to decide. Correlation coefficient will not say anything about it. Now suppose I want to, because there was a gender also, and I want to understand who performs better under the high anxiety, male or female. Or if we want to see whether this association between exam performance and anxiety level is high for male or high for female. If we want to see that, what should we do? Yes, Any suggestions from your side? What should we do? I actually want to have an interactive session, so I just wanted to talk to you people regarding that. So if you can tell me, that's fine. Otherwise, I in any case will be doing, and I have to cover a lot. So I will move fast, but can someone suggest me what to do? How can I find out the different strengths of correlations over here? Chalo, pehle chart bana ke dekhte hain. So go to graph, go to chart builder. Okay. In chart builder, now the chart type I'm taking is the second one. Second one is basically grouped scatter. This is simple scatter, first one. The second one is grouped scatter. And when you click on grouped scatter, what happens? It gives you an option to set the color. There has to be a variable on which can be used for grouping. There is a variable, gender, which can be used as a grouping variable. So just drag and drop here. Right? So I selected a second scatter plot, which is grouped scatter, wherein exam performance I kept on y-axis, exam anxiety I kept on x-axis, and gender I used as a grouping variable. Now click OK. Now you notice all green colored are female observations, all blue colored are male observation. Now where is the stronger association? And these are all random data, so don't make any inference or any opinion about it. These are all random data. So now we want to put a fit line, and this time we don't want to put a fit line only for male or only for female. Dekhe, yahan pe kya hai? This fit line is overall fit line. It is not segregating about male or female. Here we have two groups, so there has to be a fit line for each group. So once you double click on this, you will notice the sixth option also okay is right. You look at this. Add fit line at subgroups. Pehle humne ye use kiya tha. Add fit line to total. And this time we are looking at add fit line to subgroup, because there are two subgroup. There can be three subgroup. There can be four subgroup. It will fit a line group wise. And we notice this. We notice that the R square for male is greater and R square for female is less. So if I take exam performance as a dependent variable and anxiety as an independent variable, I notice that of the exam performance, anxiety can explain only 14.5% for female and 26% for male. So more strength I see with male. So they perform negative in stress. Who is able to handle more stress? Who is able to handle better stress? Or let me rephrase this. Which group of the respondent or examined people are able to handle the stress better? Male or female? What is the direction of the relationship? Negative or positive? I hope I'm audible. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Acha. So are you able to make this chart?
Sir, I just need to ask the faculty members.
Vikas sir. क्योंकि ये कोई फायदा नहीं होगा ना, मैं आगे चलता जाऊंगा तो फिर क्या फायदा होगा? If I just keep on going on, going on, going on, there will be problem. No? Sorry. I'm audible, right. Now I just want to ask.
Say you are audible.
Thanks for the information. Now I want to ask, कि ये जो रिलेशनशिप है व्हाट डू यू सी नेगेटिव और पॉजिटिव देयर इज अ नेगेटिव सॉरी
देयर इज अ नेगेटिव एसोसिएशन बिटवीन योर
नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट द लास्ट क्वेश्चन Before I proceed further, who is able to, or which group is able to handle the stress well or better? Male or female? Who is able to handle the stress better, male or female?
A female can handle.
You are right. Because there is very less. Let us find out. What is the correlation? So R square of male is 25.6%. Okay, so 0.256. R square for female, it is 14.5%. So what is this R? What is R? R is a square root of 0.256 for this one. And of course, it is negative. Kyunki relationship negative hai. And here it is SQRT, square root of 0.145. This relationship. What we notice over here, that there is greater association for male. So stress and anxiety are completely correlated. Swati, this is there's great disturbance. If we can,
yes, sir, I'm just checking. Vikas sir, is there anybody who is asking the question from their side? Because voice is not clear. Vikas sir. Sir, I have muted the participant, whatever be. If anybody is having a doubt, please come down to this room 102.
Yeah, aapse WhatsApp pe mang le kyunki time waste hoga.
Yes, yes. Either write on a WhatsApp, please.
Right. Let us start then. Aur koi baat nahi, break time mein thoda sa aap check kar lijiyega, hai na? Ki wo kya issue hai? Kyunki if I can communicate with participants. I will also feel comfortable. मुझे लगेगा कि भाई मेरी बात कोई सुन रहा है कि नहीं सुन रहा. And that is why I just keep on asking कि whether it is getting communicated or not. और हो सकता है ना someone is asking or not able to draw it and still I'm waiting.
Yes sir. Break में yes we will be check.
ठीक. So let us proceed further. And of course we understood well that let us find out what is the correlation coefficient group wise. ठीक है. जैसे यहाँ पे क्या हुआ? Here we simply saw that R square is actually given here as this linear line. So this is goodness of fit line. This gives an R square of 256 and 145. And because we knew that R square is just square of R, so we calculated its square root. We simply wrote equals to SQRT, that's abbreviation for square root. And under it, we gave the R square value. And we got the value which is equal to R. Give me R. That's very simple. And by that I see that there is a negative correlation between anxiety level There is negative correlation between anxiety level and performance, and this relationship is stronger for male and weaker for female. So I can conclude that females are able to handle anxiety better. They are able to handle the anxiety better, and they can perform better even with anxiety. Okay, now next, proceed next. The next point is to understand, ye jo calculation hai, can I get it from SPSS straight away? When we go to analyze and we go to correlate and we select bivariate, it only asks for the variables between which we want the correlation coefficient. It only asks for the variables between which we want correlation coefficient. We get, and it also gave us the output of Pearson's to the, by default Pearson's is selected. But I don't want an overall picture. I want this group wise. Maybe male, female, maybe highly educated, not so highly educated, maybe anything. Any grouping variable could be used. For that, I will have to say to SPSS that you please group your answers. Right now, there is no grouping happening, and I will have to say to SPSS, please group your answers. And to group the answers, what we need to do, we need to go to data. Please remember, there has to be a grouping variable in your data set. Right now in my data set, there is a variable gender, which is able to group, organize my entire data set. And to do that, what we'll do, we'll go to data, and there is an option of split file. What does this split file do? The total observations will be grouped by the grouping variable that you are giving. So I'm saying organize the output by group. Right now it says analyze all cases, do not create groups. If this option is selected, then there won't be any grouping. All calculations will be based on overall. But if you want to organize your output group wise, select organize output by groups. How do I go to this location? Data, split file, and there we select organize output by group and provide the grouping variable, which is gender over here. And now click OK. Once you click OK, what happens? The grouping has been done. You can see here, sort cases by gender. This is the answer you will get once the grouping is over. Now, once the grouping is over, you go to analyze again, correlate, bivariate, and these are the two variables jinke beech mein hume correlation coefficient calculate karna hai. Which one? Pearson's, because both are ratio scale variables. So we are using Pearson. Pearson cannot be used on ordinal or nominal data set. For Pearson to be used, it has to be used only for the cases where both variables are scale variables. Now click OK. And we notice here the same calculation. You can see exam performance. This is for male. Grouping has been done. First it is giving for male. And we notice there is significant association. The correlation is significant, negative, and strong. Not strong, but average, of course, average. But this is stronger than the women one, because here it is just 381. The same calculation we did here using Excel, 381 and 506. Same calculations are shown here by SPSS 506 and 381. So if you want to group your data and you want to compare the strength, you can see, right? So we understood how we can create groups on charts. We understood how we can create groups for analysis purpose and how to undo the grouping. Again, go to data. I want to remove that splitting file option. So go to split file, data, split file, and click on analyze all cases. I don't want to group. All cases are to be analyzed. Okay. And now you do, the split is off. That message is shown to you. Now entire data set is single data set. If I have more than one variable to work with, and I want to see a chart of that, then how to do? Go to graphs. Now this time we will have more than two variables together, and we will make a matrix of scatter plots. A metric of scatter plots. So go to legacy dialog box and go to scatter or dot plot. So go to scatter plot. So graph, legacy dialog box, and scatter plot. And here we have to choose that we want to go for a matrix scatter. So there can be more than two variables also now, and it will create a matrix for the same. Now go continue, define. What is matrix variable? So what are the variables for which we want? Time spent in revising, exam performance, and exam anxiety. So all three variables taken together here. And now click OK. Simple. We went to graph, legacy dialog box, scatter plot, and we selected the three variables and click OK. And when you click OK, you will notice that the scatter plot has been made. This scatter plot, look at this, exam performance and revision time. Now, if you want to see a trend line, what you can do, you can simply double click on it. Jaise maine pehle kiya tha. On the chart, simply double click. After double clicking, click on the trend line. This is the trend line. Add fit line at total. Second one is for subgroup, which is not active because no subgrouping has been done. And total is active because it is the total data. Here you see a linear line has been fit. And now click apply close. And you notice a line has been drawn. So what did you notice? Between exam performance and revision time, we see a positive association. On an average, there is a positive association between time spent and exam anxiety. We notice a negative association. So more is the time spent on revision, lesser is the exam anxiety, something like that. Khair, main cause and effect ki baat nahi kar raha. Matlab, if I'm observing greater time spent on revising, I'm observing lower exam anxiety. Therefore, there is a negative correlation between the two. The trend line also shows the same. This quadrant and this quadrant is same. These two are just replica. Similarly, this value, time spent on revision and exam performance, and exam performance and time spent on revision, these two are replica. And similarly, these two are replica. So if you have more than two variables and you want to draw a scatter plot, sometimes when you work on different variables, it is required, and sometimes you wish to report, you can simply draw it, copy and paste. Simple. Now, if you want to calculate the exit, because The scatter plot will only give you a direction where it is going to. But what exactly it is, to get that, we again need to go to correlate. So analyze, correlate, bivariate, and just add the third variable here. And this will make the matrix. So see what happening. There is a positive relationship between, not relationship, association. हाँ वो भी एक ही बात है क्या? There is a positive association between exam performance and revision time. Exam performance and exam anxiety is negatively related. Exam anxiety and exam performance is negatively related. And exam performance and this one, time spent on revision and exam anxiety is negatively related. अब जरा इसको हम analyze करने की कोशिश करते हैं. So I'm just copying this cell, this and pasting it in Excel so that I can straight away go and check. Simply click copy and paste. See what is happening between exam anxiety and revision. If I calculate R square, is this variable raised to the power 2? Acha, usme kuch aur. So it is 0.441 raised to the power 2. So actually usme stars lage hue hain na, isliye usne usko text maan liya aur calculate nahi kiya. So don't worry about it. It is equal to 0.397 raised to the power 2. So this gives me 15.76% and this gives me 19.44%. Okay. Now, what is happening between exam anxiety and revision time? So, exam anxiety and revision time. अगर मैं इन दोनों के बीच का निकालू तो क्या होगा? Exam anxiety and revision time के बीच में ये relationship है. So, 0.709 raised to the power 2, this gives me 50%. अब हमारी एक्सप्लेनेशन पे जाइए प्लीज. व्हाट वाज आवर एक्सप्लेनेशन? एंड दिस टाइम आई विल बी स्लोअर बिकॉज़ वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इट. यहीं से पार्शियल की जरूरत पड़ेगी एंड फ्रॉम हियर ऑनवर्ड्स वी विल मूव टुवर्ड्स पार्शियल. ओके, सो प्लीज अप्रिशिएट दिस. एग्जाम परफॉर्मेंस एंड एग्जाम एंजाइटी, देयर इज 19% common variance between exam performance and exam anxiety. So I'm writing this merge and write exam performance. So between exam performance and anxiety level, there is 19% common variance. तो अगर मैं एक चार्ट बनाऊं, दिस इज एग्जाम परफॉर्मेंस, एंड लेट मी चेंज द कलर. कलर यहां से नहीं चेंज होगा, क्या कलर छोड़ो बेकार में. So this says that 19% of this exam performance is actually caused by, or chhod do causation nahi, is actually explained by, or there is a common shared thing, and which is exam anxiety. So this is exam anxiety. This portion. So if exam anxiety is depending or dependent on exam performance, 19% of it can be explained with exam performance. And if exam performance is a dependent variable, then 19.4% can be explained by this. Kyunki dono ka R square is 19.4. 4%. Now, if you look at the relationship between the two, exam anxiety and revision time, there is a 50% relationship is negative. Dekhiye yahan pe. So if one is rising, the other is declining. Which one is rising, which one is declining, I'm not saying. But if one is rising, the other is declining. But there is 50% common variance. Iska matlab exam anxiety aur yani ye jo exam anxiety hai iska 50% इसका 50% जो है वो किसका है? रिविजन टाइम का है. दिस इज आर टी. सो 50% ऑफ एग्जाम एंजाइटी एंड दिस रिविजन टाइम आर कॉमन. ये कॉमन है, ये 50% कॉमन है दोनों में. एंड आई वॉन्ट टू नो the unique relationship. I want to know the unique relationship. If I wish to know the unique relationship, what I will have to do, I will have to check for or calculate this portion. This portion. देखिए क्या सीन है इसके अंदर. Exam anxiety और रिविजन टाइम में 50% कॉमन वेरियंस है. एग्जाम परफॉर्मेंस और टाइम स्पेंड ऑन रिविजन में 15% का कॉमन वेरियंस है और एग्जाम और एंजाइटी में 19.4% का कॉमन वेरियंस है. तो इसका मतलब इसका इफेक्ट यहां भी तो है ना परफॉर्मेंस पे. ये जो पोर्शन है, दिस पोर्शन विच इज कॉमन, दिस इज एक्सप्लेन्ड बाय एंजाइटी ऑल्सो एंड दिस इज एक्सप्लेन्ड बाय revision time also. So this is not unique. So this portion is uniquely explained by revision time and this portion is uniquely explained by anxiety. Lekin ye mujhe pata kaise chalega? Then what I will have to do, I will have to find out correlation between exam performance and exam anxiety after controlling for revision time. If I control for revision time, dekha tino variable mere continuous variable hai, tino variable ratio scale variables. So correlation can be calculated for all. There is a positive effect of revision time on performance and there is negative effect of anxiety on performance if I say the causality relationship. So there is some common share. This share is not unique. So what is unique? For that what we will have to do, we will have to control for the effect of other, and if we wish to control for the effect of other, we use partial correlation. If we wish to control for the other's impact, we calculate partial correlation. Agar mujhe janna hai ke what is the relationship between exam performance and revision time, then revision time in itself has a common variance with exam anxiety. So unless I control for this exam anxiety, the true relationship between the two cannot be determined. And to do this, what we do, we use partial correlation. Is this clear? Is this explanation clear? Or need to explain something, please? Someone can reply.
Sir, just give me a one minute. I just
If this is clear, because now I will be moving towards the next part, which is partial correlation.
Okay. So there is one request ki, to explain the partial correlation again.
Right. I will do that. Isliye maine pucha tha. I will do that. I will. So we have done it through a scatter plot. This is the formula which I have already explained. So I'm just I will come into later on. But abhi jo humne shuru kar diya discussion, that is on partial correlation. Yeah. What is partial correlation? Partial correlation is coefficient. It is a correlation coefficient which measures the relationship between two variables, keeping the influence of third or other variable constant. Let me show you what I was trying to say afresh. There is variable x1, y1, and z1. जैसे हमने क्या लिखा था कि सेल्स ऑफ आइसक्रीम्स एंड शार्क अटैक्स वी ऑब्जर्व सम नंबर्स हियर वी ऑब्जर्व सम नंबर्स हियर एंड वी सिंपली कोरिलेटेड विद द टू एंड फाउंड आउट सम पॉजिटिव कोरिलेशन बट दैट वाज यूजलेस. What was the factor behind it? The factor behind was temperature. The true relationship between sales of ice cream and number of sharks attacked cannot be determined unless I control for temperature. Because we noticed that during summer, when the temperature is high, people go out. They take ice creams, people go out, they swim, people and because they are swimming, shark attacks are reported more. So unless I control for this third variable, which is moderating the relationship between the two, it cannot be a true relationship between the two. For example, in our case, पहले होता क्या है वेरियंस. इफ आई हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड वाइज सम वाई व्हेन आई कंप्यूट इट्स वेरियंस सिंपल जो वेरियंस का फॉर्मूला होता है आपका क्या वाई माइनस वाई बार स्क्वायर ओवर एन ऑफकोर्स सिग्मा सिंपल वेरियंस दिस इज द टोटल वेरियंस ऑफ वाई. सिमिलरली वी विल हैव टोटल वेरियंस ऑफ एक्स एंड वी मे हैव टोटल वेरियंस ऑफ जेड. ये जो आर स्क्वायर बताता है वो क्या बताता है. आर स्क्वायर टेल्स अस व्हाट इज द कॉमन शेयर्ड वेरियंस. अगर मैं डिपेंडेंट और आर स्क्वायर क्या होता है. आर स्क्वायर इज एक्सप्लेन्ड वेरियंस अपॉन टोटल वेरियंस एंड इफ आई हैव अ रिलेशनशिप लाइक दिस. और वैसे भी जो पार्शियल रिलेशनशिप है उसमें हम कॉज एंड इफेक्ट वाले सिनेरियो को लेके इंट्रोड्यूस करते हैं. सो इफ आई एम सेइंग एग्जाम परफॉर्मेंस इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ स्ट्रेस और एंजाइटी एंड हियर एंजाइटी इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ रिवीजन टाइम. And we also understand that exam performance is also a function of revision time. Then there is something common. ये total variance है exam performance का. And if there is no third variable, this is my anxiety level, exam anxiety. इन दोनों के बीच में 19% का common variance है. अभी हमने check किया पीछे 19.4% का common variance है. So if the exam performance is a dependent variable and anxiety level is independent variable, then 19% of this variation can be explained by this model, this exam anxiety itself. फिर हमने क्या देखा कि there is a negative relationship between exam anxiety level and revision time, and it was -0.709. ये हमने चेक किया एग्जाम एंजाइटी और रिविजन टाइम के बीच में 70% का नेगेटिव कोरिलेशन है. व्हाट इज आर स्क्वायर? ऑलमोस्ट 50%. इसका मतलब क्या हुआ दैट इफ आई एम रनिंग दिस इक्वेशन दैट एग्जाम एंजाइटी सॉरी दिस वन एग्जाम एंजाइटी इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ रिविजन टाइम देन 50% ऑफ दिस कैन बी एक्सप्लेन बाई रिविजन टाइम. इसका मतलब ये जो टोटल दिस इज व्हाट एग्जाम एंजाइटी तो ऑफ दिस टोटल एग्जाम एंजाइटी 50% कैन बी एक्सप्लेन्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ रिवीजन टाइम. हमने ये भी नोट किया कि एग्जाम परफॉर्मेंस और रिवीजन टाइम के बीच में भी रिलेशनशिप है विच इज कितने परसेंट है वहां पे बताना प्लीज 15%. व्हाट इज द परसेंटेज? हाँ 15.7%. 15.7% इज रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द टू. तो ये जो पोर्शन है ना दिस पोर्शन इज 15.7%. नहीं एक मिनट ये नहीं ये नहीं ये तो पार्शियल निकालना पड़ेगा मुझे. सो व्हाट हैपेंस हियर दैट ऑफ द टोटल इंपैक्ट दिस एग्जाम एंजाइटी हैज ऑन दिस परफॉर्मेंस सम पोर्शन इज एक्सप्लेन्ड बाय रिविजन टाइम ऑल्सो. ये कॉमन आ गया ना. This portion is common. Now, unless I control for revision time, I cannot have a true relationship between exam performance and exam anxiety. So, जो ये partial correlation है, it is nothing but a process to determine the true relationship between X and Y, keeping Z constant. और कौन से नहीं कंट्रोलिंग फॉर जेड. वी यूज द वर्ड कंट्रोलिंग फॉर जेड. दैट मींस जेड विल नॉट हैव एन इंपैक्ट ऑन वाई जेड विल नॉट हैव एन इंपैक्ट ऑन एक्स एंड नाउ वी विल हैव अ ट्रू रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द टू. रिग्रेशन में मैं आपको रेजिडुअल्स से निकाल के दिखाऊंगा कि रेजिडुअल्स ऑफ एक्स रेजिडुअल ऑफ वाई एंड रेजिडुअल जेड और कैसे रिलेशनशिप तीनों के बीच में बन जाएगी. और रिग्रेशन में कोरिलेशन में नहीं. सो हियर वी हैव scale data number 1. Number 2, there is one independent variable, dependent variable. The other dependent variable is kept or controlled, and then we determine this. There is a manual calculation also possible, and there is calculation possible with SPSS. Sabse pehle main SPSS se output nikalta hu, fir manually aapko usko ek karke dikhaunga, baki dusra aap khud kar sakte hain. So let us go to analyze, correlate, and this time we will not go for bivariate. Bivariate mein it takes as it is. If we have to calculate partial, we will take partial correlation. Now, what are the two variables of interest? The variables of interest are exam performance and exam anxiety. इन दोनों के बीच में मुझे कोरिलेशन कोफिशिएंट कैलकुलेट करना है. आई हैव टू कैलकुलेट कोरिलेशन कोफिशिएंट बिटवीन दीज टू. बट आफ्टर कंट्रोलिंग द इफेक्ट ऑफ टाइम स्पेंट ऑन रिवीजन, बट आफ्टर कंट्रोलिंग फॉर द टाइम स्पेंट ऑन रिवीजन, क्योंकि अगर मैंने रिवीजन टाइम को कंट्रोल नहीं किया तो इसका इंपैक्ट एंजाइटी पे भी है, इसका इंपैक्ट एग्जाम परफॉर्मेंस पे भी है. तो दोनों का जो ट्रू पिक्चर है वो क्लियर नहीं होगा. सो नाउ वी क्लिक ओके. नाउ एक बार वापस चलते हैं. एनालाइज, कोरिलेट, पार्शियल इन वेरिएबल्स गिव द वेरिएबल्स ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. और अब तक जो हमारा इंटरेस्ट का वेरिएबल है वो है एग्जाम परफॉर्मेंस एंड एग्जाम एंजाइटी. द थर्ड और द फोर्थ वेरिएबल द इफेक्ट ऑफ विच यू वॉन्ट टू कंट्रोल फॉर, देयर कैन बी मोर देन वन वेरिएबल, यहाँ और स्पेस है और डालने के लिए वेरिएबल यहाँ, दैट वी विल कीप इन कंट्रोलिंग फॉर एंड देन ऑप्शंस में जाइए. ये बताना भूल गया था लास्ट टाइम मैं आपको, इसलिए मैं वापस आया. इसमें एक जीरो ऑर्डर देख रहे हो, जीरो ऑर्डर कोरिलेशन. इफ यू क्लिक दिस इट विल गिव यू टू मैट्रिक्स. जीरो ऑर्डर मींस नो कंट्रोल, जीरो ऑर्डर मींस नो कंट्रोल. सो इफ यू चेक दिस एंड कंटिन्यू, दिस विल गिव यू टू काइंड्स ऑफ आउटपुट. वन, the correlation between exam performance and exam anxiety after controlling for revision time and without controlling for revision time. So it will give you both. और दोनों एक ही टेबल में होगा तो कंपेरिजन करना आसान होगा. That is why I actually checked on this zero order correlation. Now click OK. Now you see what is happening. The first portion is control variable none. इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? We are not controlling for impact of any variable. So there are three variables and it is giving a matrix for the three variables. ये देखो. This is one. This is two. And this is three. ये तीन variables. नीचे देखो, ये वाला जो portion है, this is time spent on revision. Time spent on revision. This is controlled now. So now the relationship is just between two variables, exam performance and exam anxiety. अब जरा ध्यान से देखो क्या हो रहा है. Exam performance, exam anxiety, when nothing is controlled, it is minus 0.441. वही जो हम कर रहे थे अभी तक, सिंपल. ये जो हमने इसके ऊपर निकाला वो उसमें भी वही आया वैल्यू. देखो ये देखो माइनस 0.441 बिकॉज वी आर नॉट कंट्रोलिंग फॉर दिस थर्ड वेरिएबल टाइम स्पेंड. तो इट इज अफेक्टिंग एग्जाम एंजाइटी ऑल्सो, इट इज अफेक्टिंग एग्जाम परफॉर्मेंस ऑल्सो. इफ आई वॉन्ट टू रिमूव द इफेक्ट ऑफ दिस एंड देन वॉन्ट टू सी द ट्रू रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द टू, वी विल बी गोइंग फॉर कंट्रोल. Yeah, and the control variable is time spent on revision. And now this comes down to 0.247. देख रहे हो क्या हो रहा है? Significantly going down, almost going down by 0.2. यहां से comparison ज्यादा आसान हो जाएगा. The first portion is without a control. The relationship is minus 0.441. And here the correlation coefficient is minus 0.247. Here the relationship is minus 0.247. If you know this table, you can determine this value on your own using this formula. Now, how to read it? Let me take this to paint so that I can use my markers also. Look at this. This is R12. R12 is correlation between 1 and 2. 1 and 2 is the variable of interest. Variables of interest. You are controlling for third. This is control variable. Third variable. This is control variable. Ek main calculate karke dikha deta hu, baki aap log kar lena khud. Try kar lena. So this time, what are my control variables? My control variable is revision time. So this becomes variable 3. And variable 1 kaun sa hai mera? Exam performance. So exam performance is variable 1. And exam anxiety is variable 2. In dono ke beech mein true relationship dekhna hai mujhe. I want to see true relationship between these two. Controlling for this. How to do? Let us see. What is correlation between 1 and 2? मैं यहां से कॉपी करके इसको एक्सेल में ले जाता हूं. Right. This is between 1 and 2. 0.441 is between 1 and 2. ये तो चाहिए नहीं, क्या चाहिए मुझे? Correlation between 1 and 3. Correlation between 2 and 3. What is the formula? The formula is, I have written it so that I need not to change the screen. The partial correlation between 1 and 2 controlling for 3 is equal to correlation between 1 and 2. देखो ये control variable के साथ है and this is without control variable. ठीक है, so correlation coefficient between 1 and 2 is minus 0.441. between 1 and 3 it is 1 and 3 it is 0.397 and between 2 and 3 it is minus 0.709. So what the formula will be? My R12 minus R1213 into R23 divided by square root of 1 minus R13 square into 1 minus R23 square. So this is the partial correlation formula. If you want to change and calculate 1 and 3, then you will write 1, 3 controlled for 2, 1 and 3. This will become 1 and 2 and 2 and 3. So whatever it is, you just look at that. And now let us calculate. This output will be minus 0.441 minus 0.397 into minus 0.709. divided by, what's up? So not working. Let us calculate it. Achha, it load ho raha. Just hold up. Just give me a minute, it's just loading. Let me have a new sheet. Is pe bahut time lagega to main naya sheet le leta hu. Hang ho gaya to mujhe just 1 minute lagega isko hang khatam hone dijiye. And I'll calculate and show. In the meantime aap calculate karke bataiye kya answer aa raha. The formula is with you, numbers are given with you. Please calculate on your own and tell me what the output is. In the meanwhile ye bhi ho jayega. Please calculate. The system is hanged. So I'm sorry, I was quit. My laptop was hanged, and I just changed the system. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
I'm sorry that I had to quit. The system was not responding, and it wasted 5 minutes of yours. But of course, I have enough content and material today to discuss. So it will definitely will compensate definitely the loss. Okay. So did you compute the correlation coefficient over there? Did you compute the partial correlation? Swati, I think we should take a break of 10 minutes. In the meantime, I can fix the things and we'll come.
Sir, everybody is also asking for the break.
Let's take a break of 10 minutes. We'll join in 10 minutes, okay?
Okay, sir.
Thank you.